Archaeologists at Australia's Griffith University have discovered what they believe to be the world's oldest artwork. In an image released by the Australian University, the painting, which was discovered inside a cave in Indonesia's Sulawesi Island, depicts three people gathered around a large red pig. Scientists say the painting may have been created more than 51,000 years ago and can be considered one of the oldest evidence of storytelling. Philippine Neobank Zed secures a license from the Philippine Central Bank to operate as a standalone credit card issuer. The startup firm says it has received an overwhelming demand for its no-interest, no-fees titanium credit card with 40,000 people on its wait list. Zed also notes it is targeting to onboard young professionals in the Philippines who don't own credit cards yet because of their current credit scores.
Credit scores in and of themselves are flawed. The problem with them is that, you know, traditionally banks have relied on credit scores to decide on credit card applications. And it's broken because most people don't have credit scores when they're starting out, even if they have very solid jobs with very strong income potential. So what we're doing differently at Zed is we're taking in actual income data so that we can support this very promising and fast growing segment of our population that's been woefully underserved to date.
The Philippine government's debt up 2.2% in May. Data from the Treasury Bureau show the national debt was at 15.35 trillion pesos as of end May, higher by 330 billion from the end April level. BTR points to the peso's depreciation on the valuation of foreign currency denominated debt for the increase. The Philippine Trade Department releases a price guide for school supplies ahead of the opening of classes. Let's get more details with Lady Vicencio. Hi, Lady.
Yes, Denise, weeks ahead of the opening of school year 2024-2025, the Department of Trade and Industry released a price guide for school supplies. According to Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual, the list contains information on the prices of school supplies to help consumers decide when purchasing items based on their budget. BDI's Gabay sa Pumili ng School Supplies shows price ranges for essential school supplies like notebooks that can be sold for 11 pesos and 8 centavos to 52 pesos, pad papers from 9 pesos and 5 centavos to 61 pesos, pencils are sold for 11 pesos and 33 pesos, while ball pens can cost from 3 pesos to 33 pesos. A box of crayons can also go as low as 12 pesos up to 114 pesos, depending on the number of colors. Consumers can also refer to the list for prices of other essential school items. The DTI said 80 out of 117 stock-keeping units kept its prices from last year. Around 28 items increased in price, while 9 items had a price decrease. Pascual also reminded that the price guide gives consumers a choice to go for the lowest prices in the market and to inspect labels such as the number of leaves for notebooks and papers. Denise?
Thanks, Lady.
Around 27 billion pesos set to be released by the Philippine Budget Department tomorrow, that's Friday, to settle the remaining unpaid claims of healthcare workers during the COVID pandemic. The funding will cover the payment of over 5 million remaining validated or unpaid HEA and over 4,000 COVID-19 sickness and death compensation claims of eligible healthcare workers. The agency says it's a promise fulfilled for the COVID-19 frontliners as it endeavored to release the unpaid allowances earlier than expected. Back in May, Budget Secretary Amena Pangandaman said the agency targeted to settle the arrears by the end of 2025.